unsavory characters from the Terminus systems occasionally use Maji for forms of cruel sport, dumping slaves, hostages, quarreling shipmates, or even, when bored, vicious animals on the surface. One must kill the other before they will be rescued from the lethal radiation of the giant stars. How nice. We've come up with new and interesting ways to, kill and torture ourselves. Delightful. Well, here's that battle theme. Probably my least favorite, Oh, nice. Oh, the two stars, I see. Why can't we see them in the system, though? Or was I missing something? I thought I saw... Oh, that was the lights. Never mind. I thought I saw something under the world. Okay, so we got an anomaly, debris, and the Geth outpost. So let's head for the anomaly first, which is up in the mountainous region where all anomalies and outposts tend to be. So make us climb this frickin' crap. Definitely a change from the lush kind of worlds, although the last one was a kind of rocky world, but... Well, what do we have here? There's a mineral or something over here. Might as well grab it. Whee! Oh, nice. Thorium. Level, somewhat.
On my way.
Oh crap, I didn't see that. Eh. Nope. Large deposit of thorium. Okay. So we're pretty close to our destination anyway. I love that blue star. So pretty. Wee. Almost there. If we can move in that direction. Thank you. So it is down there. Whee! Boom! Well, there's two thingies? It's two. What is this thing? Is it that? Wait. I see now. Wrong thing. Boop. This strange looking sensor has some ancient graffiti scribbled on it. It appears to be marked with the Edessen colony insignia. Okay. And there's another thing right over here. Which wasn't even on the map, right? Oh, maybe that. Okay. It's closer than I thought it was. Actually, it looked closer than I thought it was. don't know what I'm trying to say. It's a thingy. It's a thingy over here. Let's get level, kinda, and,
redeploying.
And redeploy. An odd skull? This massive skull is scored by deflected mass accelerator shots. The xenobiology files in your hard suit computer can't identify the species. It must have been brought here from an unknown world. Oh my. I don't know what else we might find here. Oh, it's not. The skull is here. Oh, so we still have to go to this debris. Okay. But there's something else over here. Oh, that's the Turian wreckage. Never mind, we found that already. Head for the flag. Marker, what have you. Alright, so down here. What? Oh, up there? I thought I saw something up here. No, okay. All these tiny little things. And why do I keep hitting that? Snowblind rounds and high explosive. That's fine. And all the way over here, Geth Outpost. Which, of course, is up in the mountains again. Not exactly on the highest peak, but pretty damn close. So maybe we can get up this way. So... yeah, we'll go up here. We'll try to keep our altitude. I wonder... we're doing wheelies on the side here. I'm gathering that other axis to place we've already been. Now I'm wondering if this is going to be another... one like the last two worlds where you just kind of blow up what's nearby. Or, it's an installation that we go inside. Like the first world we went to. It's hard enough to drive this thing when it's not in the air half the time. Well, we're going to lose some altitude here. We've already damaged our wheel. We should probably repair before we get too close. Oh, I can see the baddies. Repair. What are you saying, Tally? We're being shot at now? All over there? Whence comes it? Okay, it's gotta get closer. Magnesium deposit? Do we dare get out to mine this thing? We can't get level ground anyway.
I'm on my way.
Hurry up. More positive magnesium. Okay, done. It's gotta get him, you know? Now we're not in combat yet. Where are you? Down there? Oh, I see you. Oh my.
Heads up!
Heads up! Oh, they're around us. I see. I didn't even see that one. There's another one around. Oh, I see down there. I gotta take all these things out. Someone else shot at us from down there? Oh, I see. Kinda hard to shoot a moving target, huh? Especially we can't hardly drive this thing. It kinda works to our advantage. We can't drive and they can't hit us. It's great. Geth heavy turret. Oh, he leveled up. Oh! And we got hit. Oh, I hear that thing's crackling. That's pretty awesome. Level up later. It's pretty interesting how this all staged around here. We still have the outpost itself. Can we save now? We can, so let's level. We got 2. Alright. Assault training, yeah. Increases all weapon damage, that's gonna be good. Throw, yeah, master throw. She's pretty good at that. Tally, master marksman. First aid. Oh, she's got more. Okay, how about advanced first aid? And one more. First aid, why not? Let's save our changes and let's go. Jammed again. Aha! We gotta do the zooming in thing. One more. Geth Colossus. Oh my.
Base of operations for the Geth incursion into this region.
All of a sudden we're outside the craft.
This receiver's picking up some kind of transmission. Based on the signal strength, I'd say it's coming from inside this star cluster.
It must be a message from the primary Geth base. We can use the signal to lock onto its location and eliminate them. It must be a message from the primary Geth base. We can use the signal to lock onto its location and eliminate them.
My, you're repetitive. Nothing to see around here, huh? There's like, what's she doing? Why is she running out that way?
Lead on, Commander.
You lead. I'll follow.
Nah. Okay. Scram rail, combat optics, combat exoskeleton. Okay, so it's another combat optics. 8. Perhaps Tally could use that. Oh yeah. So, journal. Find and destroy the main Geth base of operations in the Grissom system. Oh, new system. Okay, that was not there before. Or it was, but we didn't know it was. In order to stop the Geth incursion. Okay, this is a major undertaking. Well, let's check out how we're doing with the data disks. One more. These are minerals. We found all the Solarian ID tags, and we need 3 more medallions. 1 more Asari writing. We'll find some of the stuff in that last system. Okay. Check out the Grissom system. Here. Aha. Oh, I bet you it's there. That's the outermost planet. Oh, and there's our moon as well. Alright, let's check out these. It makes that sound, yeah, to tell us there's a moon. Which is probably more important than the planet itself. Benda, the innermost planet. Benda has a dense atmosphere of sulfur dioxide and chlorine, though technically classified as a terrestrial world, but the surface of the planet has never cooled down enough for a crust to form. It is a global sea of molten rock, like Zaharux. Its atmosphere is being blasted away by the solar wind. Once its thick atmosphere is gone, Benda's surface will be a mere 400 degrees Celsius. Scans of Benda uncovered an ancient Solarian vessel. A small team was dispatched to search for valuables. The only item of value recovered was a League of One medallion. Cool, another. Zaharux. Zaharux's nitrogen-argon atmosphere is being blasted away by the solar wind of the blue giant Grissom. Its surface consists of seas of loose silica dust, some kilometers deep, which periodically swirl into global sandstorms. Many unmanned probes to Zaharux have been lost over the years, though investigation has attributed all to mechanical failure or computational error. A popular extranet meme insist the entire planet is composed of dormant nanotechnology created millennia ago by a race even more advanced than the Protheans. Can we see one of these memes from the distant future? I mean, seriously. To think that everything, so much has changed and we still have memes? According to the story, Zaharux's silica dust is actually disassembler robots which periodically awaken to defend themselves. Though discounted by every reputable scientist, this theory has been popularized by a series of sensationalistic texts by Asari author Delcey Orthiza. Let's survey it and check out these robots. Nope, just a large deposit of beryllium on a small nearby moon. Okay, let's look at the planet of... Oh, there's something twinkling there. There's an unknown thing there. Okay, let's check this out. Nantanban. Nantanban is a hydrogen helium gas giant with traces of ammonia. Molecular nitrogen is present in the highest levels of the atmosphere, giving the planet its odd violet tint. The upper levels of Nantanban's atmosphere are inhabited by shoals of tiny ammonia-based life forms, no larger or more complex than the plankton of Earth's oceans. Held aloft by air pressure and wind, these bioluminescent creatures constantly flee from the approach of the Terminator. Should they be exposed to the light and heat of Grissom, they die. Yes, the Terminator is a friend of John Connor. Sulcrum Moon. Yep, we can land there. Level 1 Heat Hazard. Sulcrum is the largest moon of the gas giant Nantanban. It has a trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. The crust is composed of various metals with deposits of sodium. As with every body in the solar system, the surface is scorching hot and thoroughly irradiated by the blue giant Grissom. Surface excursions without proper protective gear are certain to prove fatal. On approach to Nantanban, Normandy's passive sensor array intercepted a fragmentary coded transmission from the surface of Sulcrum. Attempts to decrypt the message were fruitless. It does not appear to be in any software coding language used by the Citadel races. Okay, so we can land here, or we can check out this unknown thing. A rocky asteroid. An asteroid composed of mixed metals and silicates. Radius is 54 kilometers. Reveal a small deposit of polonium. Oh, that really? That's it? I figured there was something interesting with that, too. I wonder if there are other twinkling things that we can find deposits of stuff on. Well, let's go to Sulcrum Moon, then. Boom. Alright, level 1 hazard here. Okay. We've got a something that we don't know what it is. We've got anomaly and debris. Let's head for the anomaly first. I always say the best for last. Well, usually anyway. Let's go up this greenish tinted mountain. Oh, nice. Gas giant. Not gas giant, blue star. Giant blue star. Wow, what's going on? This moon, huh? Really creepy. Oh my. Up on the mountain? It looks hard to get up. See if it's around the side or something. No, it's up there. Oh, come on. They put it up there on purpose, so we have to struggle with the frickin' Mako. These guys, man. Got some nerve. Alright. Here we go. Oh! Look at that flat area. Interesting. Oh. For some reason that sound scared me a little. A sorry capsule. We'll find our last Matriarch Dilanaga thing.
Heading out.
There were several artifacts stored here, all worthless except for one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. Whether it was uncovered at this dig site or elsewhere is unclear. And yeah, we're done with that. Where would it be? Collection complete. Found all the Turium emblems, plus 3. 10 out of 10 Asari writings. Nice. Pothian data disks. One more. Oh, just right over that thing there. Well, that's the end of the operational parameter. I thought there was a baddie over there. It was red. Now let's go to the debris. A little easier traveling here. Let us go see. Ouchie, ouchie. I haven't hurt the thing yet. There it is.
I'm on my way.
What a coincidence, so am I. Crash probe, closer. In the way. Crap. Let's use our Omni Gel. Cryo explosive 8 frictionless materials. Okay. Alright, we're heading to whatever the hell that is. Gotta go on past this mountain. In a most hilarious way. Whoa, I'm all over the... I wanna go this way, damn you. We just want to play and frolic. Oh, nice. The view is always so great up in these mountains. That's awesome. It's down off of here anyway. Boom! Nose first. Getting close, let's see. I have a feeling this is going to be tougher than any of the worlds, possibly. The other ones we were just on. I can see the baddies on my map already, and I can't get up. These guys love mountains, I'm telling you. Well, I guess easily defensible position. Top of them. Oh, they're down there. We're coming! Alright, how damaged are we? Maybe we should start taking evasive maneuvers or something. Sure are. So far, anyway. We gotta go in here, right? I know, because the mission didn't end. Okie dokie. Oh, we're jammed again. Well, what? What the hell was that? I really didn't like the that sound. That was weird. Hello. Oh. Oh, I... What? Wow. What? Oh. Not good for me. That's all that's there, is just that one up there. Maybe I should run up there and get him. Ah, cool, one shot. As the last Geth falls, you hear music from across the room. Oh yeah, it was our little victory theme. On the monitor, a Quarian stands before a hushed crowd, warbling a mournful a cappella of worlds and innocence lost. The recorded song is dispatched to the Geth worlds beyond the Perseus Veil. The transmitter shuts down. Really?
I think we're done here.
Yeah. I don't think they're done with us, though. Essence lost. Transmitted to all the worlds. Okay. Doesn't sound like a good thing to happen. Why a Quarian, though? Interesting. Can we actually go in that room? That'd be great. Anything else around this room? Oh, except for this thing that gets in my way. Kit, ammo, Geth terminal. Okay, we'll save that for last. Secure crate. looks like time for. Wait, we got it. So we're gonna have to use our Omni Gel there. Another pistol, Razor 8. Armor for human and Krogan. More stuff. Can we improvement for Tally? Okay, I mean, these are close. It's the damage that it seems to have gone up significantly, so. Wait. Nope. Nope. You discover a number of encrypted Geth data files. In the proper hands, they could reveal much about the evolution of the Geth since the banishment of the Quarians. Oh, right. That's right, I actually forgot that the Quarians created the Geth. So what did that have... What did that mean? They set that up to transmit to their worlds as a signal that we've destroyed their main base. Or one of their main bases. Okay, I thought we were gonna get attacked by more stuff out here. Okay. Okay. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. What I'm going to do in the next episode, and it's probably just going to be one episode, I'm thinking, I'm going to check in at the Citadel station and run around and see if there's any quests there that have to be done or anything like that. So that'll be next episode, and yeah, Vermeier after that. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.